What's going on? It's Jessica, and welcome to CritIC, the Tox Series. Toxidromes are a collection of symptoms frequently seen in poisoned patients. Recognize the toxidrome and you'll have a better understanding of what the patient has taken, how to treat it, and to anticipate for problems to come. This first video covers the sympathomimetic toxidrome. Let's go! So imagine you're walking across the street. You turn a corner and suddenly there's a roaring lion staring you in the face. Your sympathetic nervous system will switch on. Your heart rate goes up, your blood pressure rises, your pupils dilate, and you run. There are drugs out there that mimic this state without the need for lions. This is the sympathomimetic toxidrome. Let's go through the symptoms, possible complications, and treatment with our ABCDE assessment. When assessing the patient with the sympathomimetic toxidrome, this is what you'll typically see. In A, an open airway. In B, an increased respiratory rate with normal oxygen saturation and clear lung sounds. In C, an increase in blood pressure and tachycardia, usually sinus tachycardia, and their skin feels warm. Possible complications in C are tachyarrhythmias like supraventricular tachycardia, VTach and VFib, chest pain, either caused by a hypertensive emergency or caused by coronary spasms in cocaine use, and other hypertensive emergencies like aortic dissection, cerebral hemorrhage, etc. So this patient should stay on the monitor and you get an ECG immediately. Consider treatment for hypertension. In D, you'll see dilated pupils that are equal and still reactive to light. Their EMV will be normal without lateralization unless there have already been cerebral vascular complications. And these patients will typically be extremely agitated. These patients could develop seizures. Treat both agitation and seizures with benzodiazepines. If you have IV access, and you should, give 2 to 4 milligrams of lorazepam for agitation and 10 milligrams of diazepam or midazolam for seizures. This will also have a good effect on their other vitals. In E, you'll find a warm, sometimes clammy skin, and you'll hear normal bowel sounds. But most importantly, you'll see an increase in body temperature or hyperthermia. Hyperthermia could lead to life-threatening complications like dehydration and rhabdomyolysis. Treat the visible cause of hyperthermia, like seizures and agitation, and start cooling your patient with cold blankets and IV fluids. Through our ABCDE assessment, we figured out that this is a sympathomimetic toxidrome. All vitals are upregulated. We can thus anticipate for possible complications like cardiac arrhythmias, hypertensive emergencies, agitation and seizures, dehydration and rhabdomyolysis. We should therefore get the appropriate blood work, an arterial blood gas, liver and renal panel with electrolytes, cardiac enzymes with CK, coagulation, etc. Don't forget the tox screen. We've also already started the appropriate treatment, benzodiazepines, cooling and rehydration for all patients, and we've considered antihypertensive agents. Move on to risk assessment. Can the patient tell you what he took, when, etc.? Common sympathomimetic drugs are amphetamines, like speed, MDMA, also known as ecstasy, or prescription drugs like Ritalin and Adderall, cocaine, and MAO inhibitors. Please note that drug withdrawal from sedatives like benzodiazepines could also cause a sympathomimetic toxidrome. Next, go through the general steps of treatment as discussed in the introductory video. Mind that decontamination is typically contraindicated in the agitated patient. And that's all for the sympathomimetic toxidrome. Let me know what you think about using the ABCDE approach as a tool for figuring out the toxidrome. I would love to hear your thoughts. See you in the next video.